is beyond the azure blue. A God concealed from human sight. He did disguise with heavenly hue and framed the worlds with his frame might.
There is a God.
Jesus, hold my hand. setting of the sun. Lead me safely to a land of rest if I a crown of life have won. I have put my faith in thee, dear Lord, that I may reach the golden strand. There's no other friend on whom I can depend. Blessed Jesus, hold my hand. Blessed Jesus, hold my hand.
Morning. Scripture reading this morning is John chapter 10, 22 to 42. At that time, the feast of dedication took place in Jerusalem. It was winter, and Jesus was walking in the temple in the colonnade of Solomon. So the Jews gathered around him and said to him, "How long will you keep us in suspense? If you are the Christ, tell us plainly." Jesus answered them, "I told you, you do not believe. The works I do in my Father's name, bear witness about me, but you do not believe because you are not among my sheep. My sheep hear my voice, and I know them, and they follow me. I give them eternal life, and they will never perish, and no one will snatch them out of my hand. My Father, who has given them to me, is greater than all, and no one is able to snatch them out of the Father's hand. I and the Father and are one." The Jews picked up stones again to stone him. Jesus answered them, "I have shown you many good works from the Father. For which of them are you going to stone me?" The Jews answered him, "It is not for good works that we're going to stone you, but for blasphemy, because you, being a man, make yourself God." Jesus answered them, "Is it not written in your law, I said you are gods? If he called them gods to whom the word of God came, the scripture cannot be broken. Do you see him whom the Father consecrated and sent into the world? Are you blaspheming because I said I am the Son of God? If I am not doing the works of my Father, then do not believe me. But if I do them, even though you do not believe, believe the works, that you may know and understand that the Father is in me and I in the Father." Again they sought to arrest him, but he escaped from their hands. He went away again across the Jordan to the place where John had baptized at first, and he remained. And they came to him and said to him, "John did not sign, but everything John said about the man is true," and many believed in him there.
Yeah. Now the feast of unleavened bread, called the Passover, was approaching. And the chief priests and the teachers of the law were looking for some way to get rid of Jesus, for they were afraid of the people. Then Satan entered Judas, called Iscariot, one of the 12. And Judas went to the chief priests and the officers of the temple guard and discussed with them how he might betray Jesus. They were delighted and agreed to give him money. He consented and watched for an opportunity to hand Jesus over to them when no crowd was present. While he was speaking, still speaking, a crowd came up, and the man who was called Judas, one of the 12, was leading them. He approached Jesus to kiss him, and Jesus asked him, "Judas, are you betraying the Son of Man with a kiss?" Then the governor's soldiers took Jesus into the praetorium and gathered the whole company of soldiers around him. They stripped him and put a scarlet robe on him, and then twisted together a crown of thorns and set it on his head. They put a staff in his right hand and knelt in front of him and mocked him. "Hail, King of the Jews," they said. They spit on him and took the staff and struck him on the head again and again. After they had mocked him, they took off the robe and put his own clothes on him. Then they led him away to crucify him. Finally, Pilate handed him over to them to be crucified. So the soldiers took charge of Jesus. Carrying his own cross, he went out to the place of the skull, which in Aramaic is called Golgotha. John tells us that Jesus carried his own cross. Matthew, Mark, and Luke record, as they were going out, they met a man from Cyrene named Simon, and they forced him to carry the cross. They came to a place called Golgotha, which means the place of the skull. How do I join the two? I think they're both true. I think Jesus started with the cross, and either in his weakness or strength was unable, and that's when they compelled Simon from Cyrene. Some thoughts on this. These three passages, I'm going to read the lyrics to a song. It greatly impacted me back in the day. It's from Michael Card, and Stevens typed it out, and we're going to have it on the screen. Why did it have to be a friend who chose to betray the Lord? And why did he use a kiss to show them that's not what a kiss is for? Only a friend can betray a friend. A stranger has nothing to gain. And only a friend comes close enough to ever cause so much pain. Why did it have to be a thorny crown pressed upon his head? It should have been a royal one made of jewels and gold instead. It had to be a crown of thorns, because in this life we live, for all who would seek to love, a thorn is all the world has to give. Why did it have to be a heavy cross he was made to bear? And why did they nail his feet and hands when his love would have held him there? It was a cross, for on a cross a thief was supposed to pay. And Jesus had come into the world to steal every heart away. Yes, Jesus had come into the world to steal every heart away. Lord, as we examine ourselves this morning, how many times have we betrayed Jesus? And how many times have we betrayed him with a kiss? How many times, oh Lord, have we stuck him with a thorn? How many times, oh Lord, have we hit him on the head? How many times have we spit on him? How many times, oh Lord, have we refused to take up our cross and follow the only hope that we have? As we break this bread this morning, oh Lord, I just thank you for his body, and that the Word became flesh and dwelled among us. And we beheld his glory, glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. As we take this bread, examine ourselves, consider that time, we pray we may do so worthily. We pray in the name of Jesus. Amen. It is written, O Lord, that the life is in the blood. We thank you for the life of Jesus. We thank you for the life that was in his blood. We thank you that he was sacrificed on the cross for the remission of our sins. Have mercy as we partake this fruit of the vine. We pray in the name of Jesus. Amen. Jesus.